I was born December 6, 1949 in Key West, Florida. I was a Navy brat. My dad was in the submarine service. Well, I was told that like my whole family caught polio, but I was the only one there. At that time, I had just one brother, my older brother, and everybody kind of, they got like a flu-like symptom, except me, which it almost killed me.
How old were you?
7 months old. Six, 7 months old in there. And I got so severely sick that they had to take me down to the Naval Air Station and put me on a plane and fly me up to Coral Gables, Florida, to one of the major hospitals. And my mom told me that they the doctors told my mom and dad to plan my funeral, which they did.
Did it affect a particular part of your body, or how did it affect it? Do you know?
I was paralyzed basically from the waist down. It actually got my stomach muscles, but I got lucky. It didn't affect my diaphragm. Apparently, if it did, it was very minor. Well, I remember my preschool was, I went to physical therapy, and we used to go. I can remember going to physical therapy, and then going to physical therapy. We used to go like 6 days a week, and I can remember that. Through before I got to kindergarten, which I enjoyed though. After a while, after a while, you get to be kind of working out, going swimming, and parts of it. I also remember it really hurting too. A couple of times I came out in tears, but then they wouldn't let you cry either. You're not supposed to cry.
Was there a philosophy of sorts that went with that kind of therapy?
Yeah, especially the older physical therapists. I mean, they really were trying to. I call it Marine Corps therapy, but they make you just to toughen you up. They made you expect things to be tough, and you had to just toughen up and ignore pain. That was really taught. You had to ignore any kind of physical pain or even emotional pain too. Well, one story my mom told me, we went back to Minnesota and we're walking on the beach, and the sand was 120 degrees, and it's kind of, and I fell down with my crutches. Well, they wouldn't help me up. And all these other people, well, you got to help him out. He goes, no, he's got to learn to get up by himself, which I did. And I was crying and having a temper tantrum, and it hurt. It was hot. The sand was hot, and it was actually burning. But I did get up, and which actually, in a way, it's a benefit, because I see some of my brothers are a little bit weaker than I am. I did get up, and it's kind of interesting to see how my brothers are trained and how I'm trained. But I went through high school. I had a leg brace, a full leg brace, and I used crutches all through high school. I mean, I never really walked around without crutches and leg. I've never taken a step without a leg brace ever, a full leg brace. And I've always used crutches, at least crutches and a leg brace.
Were you, when you were in school, did you get involved in athletics?
Yeah, I was. I started doing gymnastics, which kind of relates to the physical therapy. I always like working out, because I guess I got some positive. As you get older, you finally realize, well, you're being, it's like training a dog. You did good in physical therapy, so they would praise you. So then you finally go, oh, that's why, And I was always very strong. I used this physical adaptation. And, then stuff you miss out on as a kid, I never could drive a bicycle. They got these new crank ones, right? And the guy goes, well, I said, well, you got to show me how to use it. He says, what do you mean? Did you ever have a bicycle? I go, no. Or like things you miss. I always wonder what it'd be like to run. Like I remember I had my knee surgery. Well, I got to read books all summer long, right? And I got, it did make me a lot tougher, I think, than the average person. And more, I had a lot more perseverance than people. At an early age, I just realized things weren't going to be normal. So I could do the best I could do, and we were taught too as a kid to try to be as normal as possible. So most people that have polio are like type A. They're kind of trained to be type A. Well, I used to be able to walk around, but now it's like my hips are kind of wearing out, and I tore my rotator cuff in my right arm. And then, about 4 months ago, I tore a muscle in the front. Because you get older, your people have told me that have polio, the older people that have polio, and they said, well, you're real healthy now, but when you get to be like 55, 56, everything sort of wears out.
Which is, you're 55 now?
Yeah. And you get, so now it's like all of a sudden I'm getting shoulder problems, my shoulders are hurting me, and I really went over to the wheelchair to kind of control the pain, and I mean, if I didn't use the wheelchair, I don't think I could go to work. It would be.
How old were you when you started using the chair?
Well, I think I used one when I was a little kid, and probably at least maybe 12, 15 years ago, I started using it part-time. And so I'm slowly progressing over to using more and more equipment. It just makes life so much easier, too. If you'd have told me I want to be, or if I'd be using it or want to be in a wheelchair, I would have told you you're crazy. Because that's the other thing, when you're trained as a kid, you're trained to be, well, you got to stand up, you know. If you're going to stand up, it's going to hurt. And I mean, I go, why? Why should I go to work and go home and be in pain all night long? So. I remember everybody got the polio vaccine. That was not a question of should I get it? Because everybody got it. You guys put your shoes on, right? And I've done this every day, and my parents made me do it. It wouldn't help me. I had to put this on every day for 50 years. And you automatically, I pick up about 10 pounds. So if you want your kid to wear one of these, or take a chance of it, but I've had to put this on every day. And this is a set of shoes, even today, a pair of shoes to go on a leg break, that's $600. And when I was a kid too, I used to get envious of my brothers because they got four or five pairs of shoes. I got one pair of shoe per year. Even when my feet were growing, so that was a, and they're not comfortable to wear either.
And I imagine the brace had to change as you grew.
Oh yeah,
older.
Yeah. I did play baseball with my brace, which I broke. And the brace guy, my parents would get mad about that. I used to break my leg braces routinely.